scout around those original parts. And this aircraft is a perfect reproduction of those original parts. Quite notable today. As I said, the landing speed of the Bristol Scout. Bristol Scout was very successful in the early days. It was contemporary of the pre-war biplanes on the tabloid, and outperformed the tabloid largely because it had eight landing speeds. The aeroplane we saw with a higher landing speed, we certainly saw a landing demonstration pop off down the runway that the men wanted to see. And was sometimes known as the fighter that never was, because officially it didn't serve on the Western Front, even though some people nabbed it for their own personal use. Heaven knows why. But you notice the oil staining on the wheels. That is what a 1.1 aircraft is serving. So the Bremner requires about 5 litres of oil every hour because of a constant loss lubrication system. And it's interesting, notice that wind freshens at altitude now. Look at the almost geostationary Bristol Scout compared with the Bristol 1N1C downwind, hurtling towards us. If you look at David Bremner flying his Bristol Scout, you'll see, in comparison to the pristine fuselages of the aircraft, landing over on the meadow. Slightly frustratingly for us that we are not able to see or hear the sound of the blipping of the rotary engines, certainly at this end of the crowd line, because of the landing positions that are being forced upon us by the wind today. But I think it's a great tribute to all the pilots who have been flying.
the show today.